this weekend's movie release has had a rather lukewarm reaction, mainly due to it being another case of the Hindi film industry remaking a Telugu hit, trying to mimic the same success story as was the case with the original with Anushka Shetty. Durgamati is an official remake of Bhagmati that released in 2018, and it is directed by the same creator G. Ashok. The film focuses on the radar falling on a politician, Ishwar Prasad, played by Arshad Varsi, who, contrary to public perception, may be involved in the theft of several temple idols in a short span of time. As the man is revered by the public, police officials and the CBI want to conduct a thorough investigation without anyone knowing, and question the person who was closest to him during his tenure. Chanchal Chauhan, played by Bhumi Pednekar, a character that is serving time in jail, is transported to a supposed haunted mansion for an intense questioning. What eventually transpires is revelations of the dark history of the haunted house, a supposed possession by a spirit, and the officials coming to terms with the fact that this case is way more complicated than it seems. Before I get into all the aspects of the film, I just want to make it clear to everyone, especially those who haven't seen the original film, that this film is not just a horror thriller. As what may be perceived by the trailer, viewers who have seen the original know that this movie is more of a political thriller with some horror elements. So I'm already setting in your mind so that you manage your expectations. Here's me telling you the good and bad aspects of the film so that you guys can ultimately decide whether Durgamati is worth your time on Amazon Prime Video or not. The good. The B-Prak single and production design. I don't think anyone can deny that B-Prak is one of those rare Indian voices who lends his aching voice to any song, no matter how generic the lyrics may be, but elevates it to a whole new level. There is more or less one song in the entire film, which acts as a montage of the romantic storyline, called Baras Baras, and it's truly beautiful. No matter how much people want to hate on the product, the film in this case, the quality of the song cannot be denied. There are a lot of films that are set in expansive haunted mansions or guarantee a suffocating experience through its creepy characters. And a lot of you might remember these classics. From a visual standpoint, these images get deeply embedded within you. Durgamati, just like the original film, from a production design standpoint, is praiseworthy. Tariq Omar Khan has definitely captured the eerie essence of the deserted mansion. Kuldeep Amania, through his camera work, just heightens that experience, especially in the supernatural sequences. The supporting cast. This film will leave you hot and cold regarding its cast and their performances. While some actors are consistently brilliant, others have a rather hit and miss situation in this movie. Let's get through the good ones first. It was extremely refreshing to see Arshad Varsi in a dramatic role, an actor who has been typecast as a comedic relief through most of his career. Really proves to everyone the range he possesses. He has a laid-back quality to his approach with the role, which also makes it stand out and entirely different from what Jairam did in the original film. Jishu Sen Gupta is one of my favorite Bengali actors, and him as ACP Abhay Singh provides that sense of worry and vigilance required for a man who has a personal stake in the case. Dhanraj is the only repeated talent, playing one of the loyal police officers, scared out of his wits and is convincing in his role. Karan Kapadia plays the role of Shakti, Chanchal's romantic interest, and while his expression and demeanor showcase an effort by the individual, Karan completely falters in his dialogue delivery. There is a squeaky, harsh tone in his delivery that makes his performance holistically unconvincing, a role which was otherwise well performed by Unni Mukundan. Mahi Gill plays the role of Sataakshi Ganguly, the CBI officer conducting the investigation, and while it's refreshing to see her in a commanding Hindi film, an actor who I believe is really good at her craft, and she is mostly praiseworthy through the film, it was just funny to see a Bengali actor like Jishu Sen Gupta stand right next to her and notice her attempting a Bengali accent, constantly messing up her gender pronouns to convince us her last name is Ganguly. The underwhelming aspects. Dispersed format. Over a period of time of watching specifically Tamil and Telugu cinema, it's become very clear that the format and treatment of films, especially in the commercial space, is very different. While the Hindi film industry is progressing to become genre-specific, commercial Tamil and Telugu cinema is still a multi-genre format. So even though a film like Bhagmati presents itself as this massy political thriller with horror elements, it still possesses comedic gags and romance as its essential features. This in many ways doesn't translate well to an audience that is not used to such a format. What may be over the top, unnecessary and rather jarring for some actually is the norm for individuals when they step into the theater for a massy film such as this. The comedic gags of the police force, the over the top expressions, the slow motion shots and this reverbed voice of a spirit all cater to this appeal of a massy film in a theater, and it just doesn't work in the comfort of your home on your laptops and phones. Poor screenplay and too many loopholes. From a storytelling standpoint, Durgamati is treated in a very novice manner. Whenever there is an explanation or confession during the interrogation, the film transitions to flashbacks to give us context regarding what they were talking about and starts again from where we left off. If you look at the example of a piece like Criminal on Netflix, the ability of a written piece to stand out without giving you visual context of how things may have happened, all on the basis of what happens in that interrogation room, is actually a testament to the performances and how a written piece can still engross you without spoon-feeding you everything. Durgamati, like the original film, suffers from this generic amateur callback to providing context to every situation. The last 45 minutes of the film is actually where the film picks up to contribute some shape, where information is just vomited out for you to wake up from the snooze fest and realize that things are finally happening. There are countless number of fallacies from a logic standpoint, which I wouldn't want to dwell further on. Who am I kidding? This film has supernatural elements. Why am I looking for logic? But trust me, there will be several moments that will make you scratch your head and question how even these sequences or conclusions are possible. Just one example. Maybe the chowkidar of the mehel who has no arms but has a set of keys to open and close it? The obvious comparison. Bhoomi Pednekar is a performer that I really enjoy. She has sort of made a name for herself in the slice of life and self-exploratory movies. But watching her performance in Durgamati also made me realize that some actors just suit a particular pitch and genre of film. Bhoomi, I believe, is best suited for films that demand a sense of realism and thairav. I noticed through several sequences of Durgamati that Bhoomi is limited in her vocal range and especially what a movie of this pitch demands. A presence larger than life that will make someone shiver, intimidated, and even speechless. There are very few actresses that possess this commanding presence and range that speaks and impacts to the masses. You look at what actresses like Shabana Azmi in Makdi, Shobhana in Manachi Tratadzu, Vidya Balan in Bhool Bhulaiya, and even Anushka herself in the film Arundhati have successfully done. And it's the ability to haunt you and convince you of the bizarre characters. Anushka's expressive eyes, her vocal range, her larger-than-life body language, all of it contributed perfectly to even elevate the fallacies that existed in Bhagmati. Even diehard Anushka Shetty fans or Telugu cinema enthusiasts will tell you that Bhagmati was a good film. Not something spectacular, but it definitely got enhanced due to Shetty and her role as Chanchala. This is not to discount the effort of Bhoomi, but just that this medium demands something that may just not be present in her acting kitty. This movie actually makes sense from a business point of view, to get a guaranteed return on a film that would have possibly underperformed in its theatrical run, even if we in the future reach some form of normalcy. If you haven't seen the original film, the last 45 minutes with its big revelation is its biggest takeaway. At least the original film had Anushka's enchanting performance to complement that as well. If you've seen the original film already, I don't see any reason for a person to watch the same film twice, knowing very well the remake is an underwhelming attempt at mimicking that same magic. And that was the video, guys. Write down in the comments below what you thought about the movie. Please don't forget to follow me on Instagram. The handle's right in front of you. Follow me at JammyPants4. Also, please support us by smashing the like button and subscribing to our channel for weekly content ahead. Thank you for watching.